In so many ways, this moment in time is so crucial for the Shriver Center as it is for the rest of the country. Shriver's work has always been evergreen. As long as there's been poverty, as long as there's been racial injustice, we've been here fighting that good fight. This is a moment where our work is being highlighted. This is that moment where people finally see, wow, this is what you've been fighting for all these years. And so everything that we've been saying for over 50 years, talking about why it is so important for us to be focusing on racial and economic justice, people now see manifested in COVID and manifested in this period of racial awakening.
COVID-19 only exacerbated issues communities are faced with every day. Our advocacy agenda ensured policies and laws were enacted to provide immediate and long-term relief.
We're fighting to unify families in the foster system.
Parents should not be cut off from access to their children. That's why here in Illinois and across the country, advocates are coming together to push these systems to safeguard parents' constitutional rights.
We are fighting back against the cruel public charge rule.
Expand the SNAP programs.
Everybody has the right to paid sick leave or paid family and medical leave when they need it.
For housing and environmental justice.
We won healthcare access for immigrants.
We're able to take the wins that we've gotten and replicate them around the country, state by state.
Change laws and change lives. Not one, not two, not thousands, but millions of people.
This is just a fraction of our work, and there's still so much more to do. And that's why we need to use this momentum to propel our work forward.
Today we litigate, shape policy, and train multi-state networks of lawyers, community leaders, and activists nationwide.
We work with and for the people most impacted by inequity.
To pursue justice for all.
With equal dignity, respect, and power under the law.
We see ourselves as building up an army of advocates that are equipped to do their anti-poverty work with racial justice at the core.
Understanding the importance of community lawyering is understanding as a legal advocate that you are working in partnership, in collaboration with community, and you are not the lead of this movement.
There's more of an urgency when it's actually your situation, when you're the one or your family member is actually the one that's being discriminated.
There's a direct correlation between race and inequity. We can't do anything if we cannot dismantle this system.
And until we address our history and our racist history as a country, then we can't necessarily move forward to equity and to equality.
Everybody is worth opportunity. Everyone should have access to opportunity. There's more than enough resources for everyone.
This movement will end when we've actually eradicated poverty and eradicated racism.
There's power in believing in the possibility of change.
I think the misconception is that we don't need each other, but we do.
We need to make sure that our systems are giving people what they actually need to live a dignified life.
Because Black lives matter.
Black lives matter.
Black lives matter.
It's really about reframing how we value people.
Regardless of race, or where they come from.
And it means holding our institutions accountable.
This is the future we're fighting for.
Where everyone has the power to determine their futures.
Using litigation and policy advocacy to affect change where it's needed most.
Everybody has a role to play to get us where we need to go, and you can be a part of that.
We need donations to continue the work.
We need people to lead the charge.
To unapologetically tackle racial inequities.
We need to vote.
Because every single person can make a difference, and when all of us come together, we make the difference.
Please give us your ideas, your perspectives, and your voices.
You're actually part of this right now. We're all part of the movement.
No podemos hacer esto sin ti.
And we can't do this work without you.
We are the movement!